I'm from the UK, and over there it's extremely common to see people with tattoos, whereas here in China it's quite rare. However, in the last few years I have seen more and more people in Fuzhou with tattoos, and tattooing does seem to be becoming more popular. Tattooing has an interesting history in China. Like in many countries, it was for a long time associated with criminals and gangsters. There was even a time when some judges would order convicted criminals to be given face tattoos as part of their punishment. But tattooing wasn't only for criminals. For example, some ethnic minorities in the south of China used to tattoo themselves for decorative and ritualistic reasons. And perhaps the most well-known tattoo in Chinese history was the one that said, "Serve your country with pure loyalty," which was written on the back of Yue Fa, one of China's most beloved folk heroes. Yet despite this long and interesting history, since the founding of New China, tattoos have almost completely fallen out of favor with both the criminals and the good guys. So the last two or three generations of Chinese people have grown up without really seeing many tattooed people around. Perhaps this is what's led to the somewhat ambivalent attitude that most Chinese people seem to have towards tattoos today. I say ambivalent because whilst tattoos certainly aren't as socially acceptable as they are in somewhere like the UK, they're not nearly as unacceptable as they are in some other East Asian countries like Japan or Korea. I was talking about all this recently with a young artist that did a tattoo for my friend. And he told me that his master, An Laoshi, was one of the first ever tattoo artists to open in Fuzhou. So I'm going to go and talk to him and see if he can tell me a bit more about Fuzhou's tattoo scene.
97年的时候，《古惑仔》的这部电影上映了，里面有个正义剑的披肩龙，觉得很酷，很多人喜欢。然后那个时候刚刚好是我在从事这个行业的时候。 那个时候我们买不到纹身机嘛，自己生产，做的这台纹身机很重。那个时候，中国很少人纹身的时候，他们还是一些在社会上面玩那些小孩子、小混混啊，或者我们中国人会这么说他们。那现在就可能在各行各业当中都是，也在成长中。这几年吧，客户，我们的客户群会产生很多的变化，他们的。 选择的这种图案已经开始慢慢的跟过去不一样了，比如说像我们早期有很多虎啊、龙啊、豹啊，或者一些很社会的那种图案、那种风格的图案。那现在我们的客户群已经产生很多的变化，比如说像一些小女生啊，有甚至有老师、有护士啊、有医生啊、律师啊这种行业客户群来我们这种纹身。
其实中国的风格是一定会有的，话经常在神话当中是一个守财保平安
，money， 然后绳子，这是绳子。在中国的水墨画当中，我们会用毛笔来做一些渲染，来做这种粗的线条跟细的线条。像这种地方，它是属于深跟浅的这种变化，就是用水墨中的稀释的淡墨来做一些渲染。
I'm off now to meet Ao Wen. He's a student of An Laoshi. He's been tattooing for about 4 years, and he's got a pretty interesting story about how he got into tattooing.
Hey,
hi.
你好，你好。哦，给分。绿有段时间是有放在我师傅那边，可能是因为看到这个小绿吧，设计 logo 才有了灵感吧。
第一个纹身的话，那时候我还没入行之前是在我自己的老家渔民，然后那个时候船上的每个人都有纹身，然后我觉得我身上没纹身感觉比较逊，但是他们的纹身都比较丑，所以说我那时候就来福州找了我现在的师傅，就是安祖师傅，纹了一条鱼。当时离开老家之后还没有找到工作，然后就。 问了我现在师傅，我说我能不能从事纹身这个行业，然后我给他看了一些我的一些自己自学的一些绘画作品吧，然后他当时给了我一个很大的鼓励，他说，只要你肯坚持，肯学，时间就能证明一切吧，因为我看多了那些传统的一些图案，这种小图。 感觉就是第一眼看就感觉哇，很好玩，对，他有穿一条丁字裤，然后举着一条鱼。So
what are you getting done?
You're gonna get a silver.
Yeah,
an angel.
So why did you decide to get an angel done?
Well, I got a couple of other tattoos. Like, I have a panther, yeah, a dragon, and here an eagle with a dagger. And it's all a bit aggressive, right? So I was for a long time thinking about a sleeve with a Chinese dragon.
Yeah.
But it's also kind of aggressive, so I thought about something feminine.
Like, yeah, it's cool, man. Looks like it's coming out well.
So I'm off now to meet Yang Laoshi. He's not only a tattoo artist, he's also a sculptor. He actually made all these cool statues behind me. And on top of that, he's a Buddhist scholar. And I've been told that his sculpting and his Buddhism influences his tattoo style. So I'm really interested to learn about what he does.
It's me. Daniel.
将龙的这个日本传统的刺青。It's
really, really impressive, like genuinely.
我们木头做的。美术学校学这个美术，从小对这个美术就很喜欢，把家里呀都画了啊，龙啊，虎啊。到日本玩之后，学习的这个日本的这个传统的这个绘画，然后慢慢的就接触到了纹身一些图案，就感觉哇，为什么会做这么漂亮？一边学习。 一边研究，又把它变成了专业的状态，那经过了十几年吧。我自己做的比较喜欢一个狐狸的，2006年的时候去参加那个纹身国际纹身展的时候，很多纹身师还没有那么大胆，回头去看看那幅作品，还是挺耐看的。
工艺做得好，自然越来越多人喜欢。中国未来会有这个自己的独特风格，那是肯定会有的。修饰之前的纹嘛，之前纹身不好看了，然后师傅就帮我修改修改，又加了荷花，啊，越纹越大，就比较喜欢纹身了。
Now, I actually don't have any tattoos myself, and I'm not trying to encourage anybody to get a tattoo. I think getting a tattoo is a really personal decision. But I do think it's pretty cool that this tattoo subculture is becoming more popular in Fuzhou. And one of the interesting things I found is that when a lot of people think about tattoo artists or people with tattoos, they probably imagine these kind of lower class people. Whereas what I discovered is that actually these guys have a very deep knowledge and interest in art, culture, and history.
Yeah, can I? How do I do it? Sure. Yeah, cool. 谢谢您。